Okay, we're going to figure out all the trig function's values when the angle is 60 degrees. And once again, we have to remember our special triangle, the 30, 60, 90 special right triangle, right? So let me draw the picture this way right here. Let me put the right angle here and label this as 60 degrees. And we know this will be the 30 degrees, right? And the ratio of the sides in a 30, 60, 90 special right triangle is the following. This is a shorter leg, it will be 1. And this is the longer leg, it will be square root of 3. And the hypotenuse right here, it is 2, okay? So be sure we remember these values really, really well. And now you see, this is the angle. We can just do the usual business, right? For sine, it will be the opposite, which is this right here, right? This is the opposite toward the 60 degrees. So opposite is square root of 3. And then we divide it by the hypotenuse, which is 2. So square root 3 over 2, like that. And for cosecant of 60 degrees, we just take that and do the reciprocal. So we have 2 over square root of 3. Of course, let's go ahead, rationalize the denominator. So we have 2 square root of 3 all over a regular 3. Next, cosine of 60 degrees. Cosine is adjacent, which is 1 in this case, over the hypotenuse, which is 2. So we have 1 over 2, like that. For secant of 60 degrees, it will be just 2 over 1, which is just a 2. And we have tangent 60 degrees. It's the opposite, which is square root of 3, over the adjacent, which is 1. So square root of 3 over 1 is just square root of 3. And the last one, cotangent of 60 degrees, it will be 1 over square root of 3, right? So let me just put this down and rationalize the denominator real fast. And we have square root of 3 on the top over a regular 3. And that's it.